guys, a lot has happened since I made a video last. You know, post very often or anything. I normally would just post something if I thought of a song that I wanted to share a cover of because I enjoyed playing guitar. But I know in my last post I talked about finally doing my first show as a drag queen. And a lot of realizations happened in my life since then. So, as y'all know, I'm married. And I married my high school sweetheart. She's the girl of my dreams. But it's been very complicated. I finally realized that I'm transgender. I've kind of known signs since I was in third grade. But I denied it for the main reason of being from Tennessee and not wanting to push away family. Believing that God was going to send me to hell for it. Or that something was wrong with me for being the way I am. The hardest parts for me is coming out as trans meant that me and my wife weren't going to be able to last because she is not attracted to women and there's no hard feelings towards her. I still love her to death. I'm trying to work out where me and her can still be friends. And honestly, if I would have known before I got married to her that I would it was okay and be able to accept this part of me, then I would have told her that, but I had no idea because of where I was from. I thought it was wrong the way I felt for wanting to be a girl so bad. It's just taken me a long time to accept that part of me, and there's just a lot. You can tell she's happier with a man because internally, I was never a man. Especially when we have a one-year-old daughter together. That makes it a little complicated too, because we both want what's best for her. We both love her more than anything in the world. And I don't want her to feel like she's came from a broken family, so I'm going to do my best to just make sure that she never feels like she's from a separated home. I'm trying to be like best friends with my ex-wife, because I want us all to still be a family, even though we're not together. And yeah, so I really hope it works out. Keep me in your prayers in that sense, if you pray, or if just hope things work out best for me. And but yeah, I'm really learning to love myself. One of the other struggles is I can't start hormone replacement therapy yet, and I can't start the procedures to go through to transition in a medical way until the military policy gets lifted, because I'm in the Army right now. With the band, though, I just have to serve as my biological sex at work, as who I was born as. Until the policy changes, so until then, I'm just, every time I get home, I've been a woman, and then I go to work as a man. It's difficult, especially after coming out and being honest with myself, and really, really wanting this to be who I can be full-time. But at the same time, I have to respect the rules I'm given in my job, so, and I don't want kicked out. I want to continue. stars that are amazing people, and it just blows my mind that the band can even be a thing right now. Just because I know amazing people that are trans, and it's not been anything that's made them less effective at work. They actually still do like an amazing job at their job. It's still scary for me sometimes going out with like a girl, or I still feel like I'm insecure about my face. But for now, all I can do is just hope that things get better, and I'm optimistic, so I believe they will. And I just wanted all the people on here that follow me on YouTube, and it's not many people, but just to know that learning to be happy with who I am, and whether you're okay with that or not, that's really not important, because this is me. It's really hard to understand, I know, and I'm sorry if some family members think I'm just making it difficult on them, but I'm hoping that over time they'll see like how happy I am as Elizabeth and realize that's me. Family's family, and I'll always love my family no matter what, whether they love me as me or if they love me as who I used to be. Or whoever pretended to be, at least. I know it was my birth name, but, and the only reason I changed that is Evan can be a unisex name. It's just, it's one of those things when you're used to people associating that with you being a guy. It's one of those things. I don't want to be seen as a guy, so I feel more confident in myself as Elizabeth. And I feel like I'll eventually come around because they'll see how happy I am. But I can only pray about it and hope for the best. But I love you all, and thank you for listening to me vent out this and just talk about myself. Originally, I was going to play on guitar this song that I really like, but I wasn't confident in the way my voice sounded in it because it's not my normal range. HRT will change my voice a little bit, I've heard, but it's like very minor. Do like voice surgery and all that. I'm just gonna see what happens through just taking HRT to see like how it naturally changes with that. And I've normally always been okay with my voice because I'm a singer and I've learned to love it through that. And no singer really completely loves their voice. At least I've heard other people struggle with the same thing. But yeah, I wish my voice was a little more sounding like a girl. And I'm just used to hearing my voice the way it is. I've heard it's kind of like in between, so it's not like bad, like it doesn't sound too manly, and I'm glad for that at least. And other insecurities I have, I don't even like taking pictures without a filter. I do every now and then. If I get just the right angle, I like it. But as you see, I'm using a filter like right now because just I feel like it hides a little bit of things I don't like. It's still kind of there, but kind of blessed with a few feminine features that make the transition a little easier. And over time, whether it be after I get out or while I'm in, depending on what's allowed, I know I'm going to be a lot happier as the real me. So, and I hope that if you are struggling to accept people like me, that can realize we're just normal people. We just need to be able to be our true selves and be accepted. Another thing I've always been insecure about is my arms. It's one of those things. I personally believe that arms, like having like big arms, doesn't have to just be a guy thing. There's plenty of strong women out there, and I'm trying to learn to love how big I got my arms when I was obsessed with trying to cover myself with the masculinity to keep from being bullied or protect people. I'm a very protective person. I'm trying to learn to not think of that as a man thing and be confident in my arms as well. Like, I don't think they're too big. Like, they could be worse. But definitely make me a little insecure, so I'm learning to love that. Things will go better. I've been losing weight a lot lately. I lost like 15 pounds in the last month. And losing weight helps a little bit. Like, I don't want to be like too skinny, but at the same time, I don't want to have the gut that I developed when I was in Germany. A lot of beer. But I don't know. I thought I'd try this vlog thing. And I can do this more often, maybe, if that's what anybody wants. Just leave a comment saying whether you liked or didn't like it, or if you want certain questions answered that I could possibly answer in another video, and I'll try and start posting more often if that's what you want. But thanks for listening to me ramble on. It just helps me clear my head to talk to people and share a part of myself. It's nice not to hide anymore. Love you all, and hope to talk to you later. They gon' say all kinds of things. They'll make jokes about my name. They gon' try to clip my wings, but I'm gon' fly. They'll try to play me like a game.
Two-stepping, baby. I can see it.